Well, you know, I like to do a one take on demonstrating some different instruments that are fun to play. I have on some others before, and I'll do some more as time goes on. But this is one of my most fun, most favorite ones, just the Washtub Bass. The old mountain folks made a bass out of a washtub when they didn't have a big upright bass to go with their homemade banjos and fiddles. So it's just a marvelous instrument. You get about a 1.5 octave of range on it. You can get really low if the conditions are right, and fairly high, not as high as an upright, but lower than an upright. You can do about anything you need to do with the bass as a washtub bass. I messed around and put some nice stickers of old tractors and barns and things, and I have like a G, C, D, and A on it, so I can turn for to get in the key. Not really, but it's kind of fun to play with, and I just have a good time with it. I've played a wedding, I've played a funeral, and I've played a ton of other gigs with a washtub bass. And it is one of the most fun things to play because it's such a conversation piece. When you get through playing, people love to come up and talk to you about it. So I'll just demonstrate it on a song. If you can hear and match tones with a band, you'll get most of the notes. I don't get all the notes. I miss some here and there, so you'll have to forgive those. But if you can hear and make up a bass part in your head and try to match the band that you're playing with, you don't care what key they're playing in, none of that means anything to you. You're just going to listen and play. So it's probably 95% ear, 5% mechanics, because there's not much to mechanics on pulling a stick and a rope. There's just a knot on the other end of here, a knot on this end of there, a stick with a little groove in the bottom of the stick so that it will fit on the lip. You sit it up here on the lip of the tub, put your foot here so when you pull back you don't lift the tub up but actually get the string tight, and you simply tighten it to go higher and loosen it to go lower. That's all you do. You may have to turn your bass up on your speakers. If you've got an ability to turn treble and bass, you can turn the bass up a little bit because a lot of movie cameras don't capture the bass real well. I'm going to try to play a song with Allison Krauss. It won't be perfect because I just do one take. And if I make mistakes, I make mistakes. Who would think about playing a bass, washtub bass with Allison Krauss? I would. I'm going to try it at least. So here we go. Let's put this good lady on. She's so good.
I've got all this and
Washtub Bass. Trying to think, there was something else I was going to say. If you get one, don't go buy a brand new one, because they're too thin a metal nowadays. They're too cheap, and it won't work. And so you need to find a good old one somebody will give you from an old farm that's kind of stout, but not too stout, or it won't make any vibration at all. And you have to take the handles off of it, or they'll rattle you to death. Alrighty, hope you enjoyed that.